Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Computer Wednesday. So today we're going to take a look at NAS, Network Attached Storage. So let's dive right into it. So question comes to the mind, what is it? To understand it very simply, you have to understand what does it allow. So it allows hardware redundancy. What does that mean? Think of it this way, like let's say you have a hard drive in your computer. If anything goes wrong with that hard drive, all the data that is in that hard drive is gone. Now RAID array that is used in network attached storage, now sometimes alternate can also be used, which allows you to have a system where you can, let's say for example, I have four hard drive and one could be lost, anyone. It's not like, okay, this one is the only redundant one. Anyone can be lost and yet you will still retain full data. So this is the part of NAS which we call hardware redundancy. It allows you to have redundant hard drives. So let's say, and it's up to you how you design it. It's like some people in 8 hard drive system may have 4 redundant drive if let's say data is very high priority. And the more redundant you make it, the faster speed you get. So you can get that. And it also acts as a central backup point. So generally NAS is connected to network. So network can communicate with between your mobile phone, your tablet, your laptop, your desktop. It acts as a central location which has some level of hardware redundancy, and you can backup everything to one location. Like let's say, so in that case, if your computer hard drive dies, you can buy a new one and restore it. So that's the use case when you want to use it for backup. Other things also allows you to understand it very well is that, think of it as simply, it's a server in your home. It's a local server, and it also allows you to have multiple users connected to same hard drive. Like NAS unit is generally minimum of 2, maximum, well, it can go as big as a server. So suffice to say, you can run multiple users in your network attached storage. So that's what it is. So question comes to the mind, why it is? Well, you have to understand this very simply. Internet is not cheap, not even today. You can't just get 100 Mbps connection everywhere, and it's not even possible on mobile devices yet. Even with 5G, you will not get 100 Mbps, practically speaking. And so let's say somehow you manage to pay for that internet. Here's the problem. On top of that, you have to pay for, you know, your cloud storage, and that's also very expensive. So price is the main reason. Ideally, people would like to do it on cloud storage servers, but it's so expensive, it's pointless. And then on top of that, one thing that your local, you know, NAS has over all the service, even if you can bypass all this, is that LAN speed and latency is quite precisely unmatched. Like there is no connection that will allow you to have the redundancy, the speed, the reliability of a LAN connection. So let's say your network attached storage is acting as a video drive, where you know you are putting all the videos you shot from a camera and then editing on the network. It's doable, but if you try to do that with on internet, yeah, even with 100 Mbps you're gonna have serious issues simply because of the latency and all that involved. So first, internet is way too expensive. Second, LAN is cheaper and more, you know, reliable, redundant and all that. So how can you get into it? Now in recent years, routers like this Asus router has come into market, which generally has a USB port into it. Now not all router that has USB port has this feature. Some of them only allow you to connect a printer, which allows them to do network printing. And this is a very cheap and easy way to get into it. Earlier, these routers used to be very expensive, like hundreds of dollars. Now you can get them in sub-$100, or in Indian case, you can easily get them at 3,000 to 5,000 rupees. However, be mindful, this is a very cheap and quick solution. It does not give you any hardware redundancy. So if this drive fails, your network is gone. So unless you can have something that has, like, you know, 2 clone hard drives into it, some enclosure does allow this feature that, you know, your data is parodied into 2 drives. In that scenario, you can connect that to this and get you know, quick and dirty network attached storage. Second, the actual way to get a proper network attached is something like this, which we call NAS enclosure. Now the reason we call it enclosure is very important, is that they never come with drives. So this is very expensive units. It's not like, you know, you're just gonna go and buy them. They cost a lot. Like they are basically a compute and given the fact that they are in not mass production, they also cost a lot. So expect to spend upwards of $500 to $600 to even thousands of dollars on network attached, and then you also have to buy the hard disk. But this allows you to have everything. This has the hardware redundancy and the endurance. Like, this cannot feed the data at very high rate because only few router even today comes with USB 3.0, and those who do cost almost as much as this one. So suffice to say, if you get that, and they also come with a lot of other secondary features. Like, one of my personal favorite feature is that they will clone the data to another cloud storage, but they will only do it, like, you know, once a night, and they will delete the older backups. So you'll always have a latest backup, but you will not have, like, you know, old backups piling up, so you lose your cloud storage data. And they can also, you act as a download station where you can, like, you know, let's say you are downloading some big file, a big movie or a big Netflix series, and you can simply forward the download to it. It will download it, and your mobile can be free to do anything you want. So that's why they are quite, they are the actual reason why we even have NAS. These are small business and home use case scenario. So there are some bells and whistles that comes into context when we are talking about network storage. One is that you have to buy what we call is array scale hard drives. Basically, they call it network hard drives. The reason is that, as you can saw in the last image, the enclosures are quite small. So you put hard drive as close to each other, like they are very closely stacked. So vibration from one jumps to another. So when you have that, your hard drive will die very quickly if it's not designed to handle it. So that's why there are, every company generally releases a network specific or storage specific, or sometimes they flat out might say, you know, NAS hard drive, as Western Digital Red Drive does. So what they allow you to have, like, the engineers that build the hard drive, they designed it so it can handle high temperatures because it's so close to each other. They can handle high vibrations, and they can handle being turned on 24/7. So suffice to say, if you bought the enclosure and then you bought cheap hard drives, then you know, normal grade hard drive, when you put it into the enclosure, your enclosure is not going to give you any performance, and it's going to die very quickly. And be mindful of one thing: if your hard drive dies, like, let's say you had a 4 drive system where one hard drive died, you can replace it. Yes, that's true. But all those 3, you can't pull it out of the RAID and then read it. That's not possible, unless you have to go to a backup agency that deals with this sort of thing. It's not gonna work. So be mindful. So cheaping out on the hard drive end is unwise. And the second, this is very important for small scale business, and large scale business rely on it. It's called link aggregation. So what does that do? Link aggregation, as you can see, this is a Synology disk station. It has 4 Ethernet ports. So why does it have that? If you have a lot of hard drive, you can handle large data throughput, and while having redundancy. So in that scenario, they can have an array that can give out data at 400 Mbps. So okay, you have 4 wires to send 100 100 100 100. Then you send that data to what's called a link aggregated switch, something like this. Now, not every switch can do that, so please make sure you check the switch, which allow you to take that truncated cable, basically 4 cable, and then the switch can divert the data. What does that benefit? That means you will end up with a local storage server that is acting as if it has data connection of 400 Mbps. So let's say somebody is taking file that is so big that it needs high speed, the switch can give it. Or let's say a lot of people are using it, you don't have the bottleneck of 100 Mbps. So that's why link aggregation is very important for small scale business, and large scale enterprise runs on it. So this was my very quick and precise summary of network attached storage. I hope you liked it and learned from it. In that case, please like. If you didn't, dislike, leave a comment. Please subscribe, press the bell icon. I make the video every day. Thanks for watching.